Welcome to my channel, let's get crafting.
Our supplies are really simple. Two chalkboards from the Dollar Tree, and then you're gonna need two bundles with a little bit extra over, so 23 of these painter sticks that you can get from your home improvement store. And we are gonna be making a really, really cute crate that you can write on the front of it to customize it, whatever you have storing inside of it. And it's gonna be so easy to use. We're gonna be using this little portable miter box that I use all the time here on my channel and my little hacksaw. So what I'm doing right now is I'm creating a mitered edge frame around my board. Now you could always just do straight lines, but I really love the idea of pushing my creativity like I talk about on my channel here a lot, where I want to miter the edges to give it that more custom high-end look. So first I'm gonna have two longer ones with the mitered corners, and now I'm just measuring out the sides that I need for two smaller ones for the smaller side of the chalkboard. So once you've got all those cut out, you're gonna add some glue, hot glue or wood glue, whichever you prefer. I'm just using hot glue because I'm gonna come back in on the back side of it once I'm all done stapling everything together with some hot glue and some wood glue at that point, and that's gonna really secure it and strengthen it. So at this point, you can see that I've glued my frame all together and I've glued on my chalkboard, and now I'm just deciding what size staple I will need inside my staple gun. And then I'm just gonna load that right inside and then start stapling everything that I need. I love using my staple gun. You see me use it here a lot on my channel because it really does help you create high-end DIY looks for almost nothing. And it's amazing when you go to home decor stores and you see that the supplies they use are basically what I'm using here in this video. You can make so many cool things using a staple gun and a miter box. So here I am, I just stapled them all together so it's nice and strong at this point. And then in just a second, we're gonna go ahead and start adding on the actual crate itself. So at this point, just make sure you line everything up because you want to make sure your lines are nice and straight as possible. Otherwise, you can have something look a little wonky and then things won't line up as well. So here I am, I'm just adding on the last piece of my frame for my other chalkboard. And you could technically just only do one chalkboard on one side if you want, but I just love the way it looked with having the chalkboard on both sides and thought that this would be so cute to be able to write whatever you want on it, that the supplies you have inside of it. You could use it in a pantry, you could use it in a closet, you can even put it out just as decor. I just think these are so stinking cute. So once you've got the two of them all stapled together and they're nice and strong, you're gonna go ahead and lay out your sticks, your painter sticks, deciding on what length you want and how much spacing you want at the bottom. I went ahead and did, let's count, seven. I had seven at the bottom. I had to think there for a second. Seven at the bottom and four on the sides. So this is why I came up with using 23 of these painter sticks. And each one of these painter sticks packs that you can get from your home improvement store, there's 10 inside a pack. So I just ended up picking up three. So the total cost to make this was under $5 because I didn't use that full pack of that third painter sticks because I only used three of them. So here I am at this point, I'm just lining them up onto the side. Now I will say the first couple shots that I did on this, I missed it, but your staple gun is gonna have a little marker line on the side, and if you line that up to the wood, you'll be able to see exactly where it needs to shoot in, and it'll be able to clear it without having it coming out on either side. And it works perfect. So you can see here that I'm actually in my groove. I ended up getting the staple just right and it was going through each time, and I keep checking underneath to make sure it didn't slip through. And it was all stapled together nice and strong. Now at this point, I'm gonna go ahead and flip over to the bottom. And I did the two sides first because I wanted to make sure that those were not kind of wonky at the end. Those are your jumping points for being able to make sure everything else is spaced nicely. And then once you go ahead and get those, you can staple on the rest. Now at this point, you have created yourself the cutest crate ever. And I'm gonna take some wood glue, like I mentioned. The Dollar Tree is actually carrying wood glue now in their crafter's corner, which I'm so excited about. So I'm going back in with some wood glue in all of the spaces, and I'm just going to make sure it's nice and glued together. and I let it dry. Once it was dry, I went ahead and took some white paint and I went ahead and painted the thing all over with white paint wherever the wood was. I wanted some of the wood to still show through, so I was kind of doing more of a whitewash on it because I thought that that would be really cute. But how adorable could this be if you painted it whatever color you wanted for the room that you're putting it in? It could be so cute in a little girl's room if you paint it pink, or a boy's room if you paint it blue. So many options. Today is the DIY challenge where we are all making coastal or farmhouse summer inspired DIYs. But first, I wanted to give a real quick shout out to my friend Hillary over at Old World Home. Friends, she's so close to reaching 100,000. Will you go over and check out her channel and give her some love? She is the cutest family vlog channel, and she's the creator of the $5 Goodwill Challenge. I just know that you will adore Hillary as much as I do. She has such great morals and standards and does such a wonderful job raising her family. Go give her some love and check her out. And real quick, if you love to play along to the DIY challenge, the next DIY challenge is going to be on August 14th, and the theme is back to school. You can either do teacher's gifts or home decor that you would use in your house to celebrate the going back to school season.
For all of my friends returning, thanks so much for coming back to watch this video. And if you are new, please don't forget to click the subscribe button.
For our next DIY, we are going to be using this stair spindle or stair rod. I don't know. I always call things so crazy here on my channel. And these wood rounds that you can get at the Dollar Tree. This DIY is gonna be so easy and so quick that when you see how quick I make these candle stems, you're gonna think, why do stores charge $30 to $40 for these? So here I am, I'm just gonna take this and cut it in two places because we're gonna be making two really beautiful farmhouse candle stems. All you need to do is cut them down to the desired length that you want, and then you're gonna take a drill and you're gonna pre-drill holes on both sides. This is going to allow you to be able to make sure the wood doesn't splinter, and it will also help you just kind of guide the screw in easier so that your candle stems don't end up wonky or crooked because we don't really want that when we're dealing with candles. I would also recommend that the non-lighting candles, the battery-lit LED candles, are really pretty on these too. If you don't feel comfortable with putting an open flame on them, that's totally understandable. These are just so cute on a mantle. So now at this point, I'm gonna also pre-drill holes into the wood rounds from the Dollar Tree, and then I'm gonna go in with a bigger drill and I'm gonna do a countersink hole. I'm not going all the way through, I'm just barely going through the top, and then I'm kind of wiggling my drill around a little bit to create a larger opening, and this is going to allow your screw to sink down in there. That way you won't see the screw sticking out and it won't scratch your table, and it'll have a nice finished look. Once you've got all of those done, go ahead and take your screw, and I'm going to use a really nice long screw because I want to make sure these are really secure and strong. I'm going to go ahead and start drilling through the round first. Then you're going to see here, I'm going to take the bottom and I'm going to just line up that pre-drill hold that you saw earlier. I'm gonna hold my hand back so it's not in place of getting hurt. And then I'm gonna go ahead and just drill it all together. This is so easy to make, friends. And each candle stem cost me, I'm gonna say $2.50 to make, because each round was a dollar, and then the stem, the railing stem or spindle, that was a dollar from my local refurbished store. Then what you're gonna do is you're gonna go ahead and just screw on all of the other tops and bottoms. I'm using a wood round at the top and the bottom because I thought that this just looks so chunky and really pretty. And then now I'm gonna just take some white paint and just add a little bit to it. I actually like the wood color tone that was on the wood rounds from the Dollar Tree. And I'm just gonna add some paint around it, not covering up the whole thing. And then because the spindle itself was already kind of an off-white pretty color, I'm just gonna simply go in and just add a little bit of white paint so it looks, you know, distressed, farmhouse looking. And then that's pretty much it. You're ready to add your candles and display. Thank you.
Leave a comment down below to let me know which one was your favorite and if you'll try any of them. If you aren't following me over on Instagram, go over there and say hi to me. I love peeking inside of all of your craft rooms and being able to see what you're up to. So please do come by and say hi to me. And if you like a home cleaning channel with lots of motivation within your home, go on over to my Heidi Sombol home channel and click the subscribe button. I always take my DIYs here from my channel where I DIY them, and then I put them within my home and you get to see where I decorate them all around the spaces of my home. And until the next episode, bye friends.